Lakshmi Prasanna, Assistant Professor, Department of ECE, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. In this session, we will discuss about some assembly language programs to perform code conversions by using 8086 microprocessor. So, in order to write the assembly language programs, the addressing modes and instruction set of particular target microprocessor is very important. Here the target microprocessor is 8086 microprocessor. So the programmer should have idea about the instruction set and addressing modes related to 8086 microprocessor. So here generally assembly level language programming is a low level language programming. We will write the programs by using mnemonics that can be easily understandable by a user. So here generally this code conversions include converting the one number system into another number system. So here in this session, we will discuss about different code conversions like packed BCD to unpacked BCD and how to convert packed BCD number to ASCII and how to convert hexadecimal number to ASCII number. Here, first we will see how to write an assembly language program to convert packed BCD number to unpacked BCD number. So, first we should know what is a packed BCD number and if you make that into unpacked BCD number, how the value will be changed. So, here for example, consider a packed BCD number. So, for example, consider here the packed BCD number is 72, for example. So, if you convert this number into unpacked BCD, then it becomes 0702. So, here the packed BCD number what we are taking is of 8 bit. So, this 72 is a 8 bit number. After converting that into unpacked BCD number, it becomes 0702, which is a 16 bit number. So, here the value what we are taking packed BCD number can be stored by using any 8 bit register. And after converting that into unpacked BCD, the result should be stored by using 16-bit register. So, not only this 72, for example, if you take one number like 59, it is a packed BCD number. If we unpack this number, it becomes 0509. So, similarly, for example, if we take another number like 68, so, if you unpack this number, it becomes 0608. Okay. So, this is how we have to convert packed BCD number to unpacked BCD number. So, in order to make this type of conversions, we should know how to write an assembly language program. That means, what are all the instructions that we have to use in order to execute this packed BCD number to unpacked BCD number. So, for example, let us consider a value 72 and write a program by using instruction set and addressing modes. And we will see how to write an assembly language program. Now, so this is the assembly language program to convert packed BCD number to unpacked BCD number. So, here first we have to clear the accumulator. That means here we are taking only one number and we are that is packed BCD number, only one number we are taking and we are converting that into unpacked BCD number. So, since we are taking only one input, we can use register to take that input, and we can use another register in order to store the 16-bit output. So, in another case, if we are taking more number of inputs, in that situation, we have to go for using the memory location. But here we have considered only one input, so we can use registers and write the program. So, according to the logic of the program, we are going to store the result in the accumulator. So, we know AX is an accumulator and it is a 16-bit register. So, in order to store the value in AX register, we have to first clear the accumulator, because there may be any previous result stored in the accumulator. If you are clearing that accumulator, whatever the result that is stored will be exactly for our program. So, that is why in order to clear the accumulator, that is AX register, we are moving this 0000 value into AX register. So, if you do this, the value 0000 will be moved into AX register. So, accumulator, AX register means accumulator, it is a 16-bit register. If you move all these zeros into AX register, the accumulator will get cleared. And next, move AL, 72. So, what it means here, we are going to take one packed BCD number. And here the packed BCD number what we have considered is 72. So, that 72 is a 8-bit data. So, that 8-bit data should be moved into 8-bit register. So, move AL, 72 means the value 72 will be moved into AL register. Now, we are taking this 72 as the input value. You have to unpack it. That means you have to take this 72 into 0702. So, in order to make that, you have to use proper instructions like AND, SHR, and move AH, AL. It means move the value which is present in AL register into AH register. Because whatever the registers that are there soon after the mnemonic, those comes under destination, and here after destination you will have source. So, when that instruction is executed, the data that is present in the register will be moved into destination. So, move AH, AL means the value which is present in AL register will be copied into AH register. So, here what is the value present in AL means here 72, that is the input. And next instruction is AND AL, 0F. That means we have to perform here the AND operation between the contents of AL and 0F. After performing the AND operation between these two, again the result will be stored in this AL register only. Why? Because this register is there in the place of destination. After performing the AND operation, see, AND operation is performed between the contents of AL with 0F. So, here to perform the AND operation, so AND operation, what is there here in AL? So, AL consists of, here this is 72. So, AL consists of 72, and that 72, if you write in the form of binary, the value of 7 is 1110. And here this is 2, so 1000. So, this is the 72 value in the form of binary. So, this 72 value which is there in AL should be AND with this 0F. So, here 0F, in order to represent that in the form of binary, the value of 0 is 0000 and the value of F is 1111. So, in between these two, we have to perform the AND operation. So, AND operation means, according to the truth table of AND gate, if both the inputs are high only, the output will be high. Otherwise, it will be 0. So, here you will get 0100000. So, here if you convert that into hexadecimal, this is 0 and this is 2. So this is the output after performing the AND operation. So we got here the value 02. And here this 02 will be stored in AL register only. Why? Because it is a destination register. So in AL register, this 02 will be stored. Okay. And that is what in this line the operation will be performed. And we are having now in AL 02. And next instruction is move CL, 04. So it represents, so here it represents CL, 04 means 04 will be moved into CL register. So what here the value CL represents? CL represents here counter register. So 04 is the value moved into CL register. It means the count value is 4 now. And so after this instruction, there is SHR, AH, CL. So what is here SHR? SHR represents shift right. Okay. So SHR represents shift right. So SHR, AH, CL. So it means SHR. So what is there in AH register up to now? Here AH value is 72. So 72, comma, and what is the value of CL means 04. So this represents the count value. That means how many number of times the shift right operation should be performed. Okay. So shift right operation should be performed for a value 72. Now consider here, this is 72. We have to write the value 72 in the form of binary. So here it is 1110 and the value of 2 is 0010. Now perform the shift right operation by 4 times. So shift right operation means the shift operation will be performed in this manner. Each bit should be shifted towards right by 1 bit. So if you are shifting the bits towards right, the leftmost bit, MSB bit, will become vacant. That MSB bit should be filled with 0. So if we shift 0100110. Okay. So here this bit comes under carry bit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, only 7 bits are here. Here is the vacant bit. That vacant bit should be filled with 0. So this is the shift 1. That means one time shift operation has been performed. Okay. So the counter is 4. Like this, we have to perform 4 times shift right operation. So one time has been completed. If you shift this again towards right, the next it will be 1001110. So after performing this, this bit will be coming under the carry bit. So we have to neglect that carry bit, and the remaining bits, if you count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 only. But it should be 8 because the leftmost bit here, it is a vacant. We have to fill that with a 0. And next, this is a shift 2. And another time, if you shift, it becomes 0011100. And here, this is a carry bit and it will be neglected. So the leftmost bit will be vacant. It should be filled with 0. And so this is the shift 3, that is the third count it is. And if you perform the next time shift operation, next it will be 0111. Okay. And here 0000. This is the 1. So here this bit comes under the carry bit. So it should be neglected. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, only 7 bits are there. The leftmost bit is vacant. So that vacant bit should be filled with 0. So if you are filling that with a 0, so this represents the 4th shift. So since here counter is only 4, we have to perform only 4 times the shift right operation. And what is the value we have got here? It is 0 and this is 7. 07. Now, according to this instruction, after performing the shift right operation by the value which is present in AH by CL number of times, that is 4 times, again the result will be stored in this AH register. Why? Because it is in place of destination. So this 07 will be there in AH register. Now, AH will be handling the value 07 according to this. So AH will be handling 07. Okay. And last instruction is INT 03. INT 03 represents end of the program. End of the program. So now here whatever the value we have taken is 72. If you unpack that number, we have got here totally, it will be stored in AX register. So that is why here we have cleared the accumulator initially, and we know that this AX register is divided into AL and AH. Why? Because this is a 16-bit register, AX. It is divided into 2 8-bit registers, that is 0 to 7 and 8 to 15. So here in place of AL, we will have 02. In place of AH, we will have here 07. So in this way, this 72 packed BCD number has been unpacked and we got the result in AX register as 0702. So similarly, we can take here any input, and if you want to convert that packed BCD number to unpacked BCD number, we have to properly use the instructions and shift right. So this is the program to perform the packed BCD number to unpacked BCD number conversion. And so here we have to write the input and output. So in the program, we have considered a register AL and we have taken the data 72, which is a 8-bit data. Okay. So this is a packed BCD number, what we have taken as input. And here after converting that, we have got the unpacked BCD number as output, and it is stored in another register, that is 16-bit register AX, as 0702. Now, and the next conversion, second conversion is here, packed BCD to ASCII. So whatever the number we are going to consider as input, that input should be packed BCD number. And that number, after converting that into ASCII, how it is going to change? American Standard Code for Information Interchange. So here, packed BCD number. So for example, consider the packed BCD number. In this case also, consider, for example, we are taking the packed BCD number as 72. So to convert this, this is a 8-bit data. So while writing the program, we have to use the 8-bit register and you have to move this 72 into that register. And here, after converting this 72 into ASCII, we have to do first this packed BCD number, convert it to unpacked number, convert into unpacked number. So if this 72 is converted into unpacked number, just we have seen, it will be 0702. That means we are going to get 16-bit data as the output. Now, so to convert into ASCII, we have to add 30 to this unpacked BCD number. So if we add here 30 and here 30, then the value what we are getting is the ASCII value. That is your output here. So if you convert here, this becomes 32 and this 7 and this is 3. So this packed BCD number is 72. After converting that into ASCII, it will become 3732. So before converting into ASCII, between you have to convert this packed BCD into unpacked. Then for that unpacked data, we have to add the value 3030. Then only it is called as ASCII output. So the same program here, what we have observed in the previous program. So move AL, 56. So for example, here we have considered this 56 as an input. So in this case also, we have considered only one input, that is 56, and we are converting that into ASCII number. So since it is only one input, we can use registers and write the program. So here also, if you want, you can write the one instruction before this, that is move AX, 0000. You can use in order to clear the accumulator. Why? Because this program output also will be stored in the accumulator only. So we can use this instruction if you want. So the value 0000 will be moved into AX register. And so move AL, 56, because here we have to take packed BCD number as a input. So here we have considered the packed BCD number as 56. So this 56 value will be moved into AL register. So the now value of AL is 56. And move AH, AL means, so the value which is present in AL register will be moved into AH. So here AL register value is 56. So 56 value will be moved into AH register. And AL, 0F. So AND operation will be performed between the content present in this AL with 0F. After performing the AND operation, the result will be stored in this AL register only. Why? Because this AL register is placed in the destination. We know the format of general format of an instruction, mnemonic, destination, source. So the AL is in place of destination. So after performing the AND operation, the result will be stored in the destination only. Now, so here the value of AL is 56, and if you convert that into binary value, 101, the value of 5, and 6 is 110. Okay. And this 56 value should be AND with 0F. So if you perform the AND operation, first we have to write in the form of binary. So the value of 0 is 0000 and the value of F is all 1s. Now after performing the AND operation between the two contents, so according to the truth table of AND gate, the output will be high when the two inputs are high. So here it is 0, 1, 1, 0, and this is 0, 0, 0, 0. So this is the value, and here if you convert that into hexadecimal, so this is 0 and this is 6. So after performing the AND operation, the result will be stored in AL register. So according to this, the value of AL register will be 0, 6. So here AL will have a value 0, 6, and move CL, 04. So this 04 value will be moved into CL register. So here the counter value is initialized to 4. And next one is SHR, AH, CL. So here SHR represents shift right. So here shift right operation will be performed between AH by 4 times. Why? Because here the value of CL is 4. So first we have to know what is there in this AH register. So according to the program, the value present in AH register is 56. Now we have to consider that 56. First, this 56 should be written in the form of binary. So the value of 5101 and the value of 6 is 110. Okay. And this 56 is the value which is present in AH. This 56 value should be shifted towards right by 4 times because the CL value is 4. So if you perform the shift right operation, the data will be moved towards right by 1 bit. So the leftmost bit will become vacant. We have to fill that bit with a vacant bit. Now, if you perform the shift right operation, so here 0110 1010. So this bit comes under carry bit, and here this carry bit will be neglected during the shift operation, and the last MSB bit will become vacant. It will be filled with 0. So this is the shift 1. Like this, the shift right operation should be performed by 4 times. So this is the one shift, and if you perform another time shift right operation, so here 110 1010 0, and this bit comes under carry bit, which will be neglected, and here the MSB bit will become vacant. It will be filled with 0, and this is for shift 2. And for the third shift operation, 101 01 0 0 0, so this is the carry bit. It will be neglected, and this comes under shift 3. So here the leftmost bit will become vacant. We have to fill this with 0. And another time shift right operation, then 0101 0000. And here this is the carry bit. Here the leftmost bit will become vacant. We have to fill that with a 0. So this carry bit should be neglected. So this is the shift 4. So only 4 times the shift right operation should be performed. After that, we have to convert this into hexadecimal. So this is 0 and 0101. So the value is 5. So after performing the shift right operation, the result will be stored in AH register. So this 05 will be stored in AH register. So in AH register, we can observe the result 05. So totally this AL and AH register here, the next instruction is RAX, 3030. So up to now, this is a packed BCD number. That BCD number have been unpacked. After unpacking, the value of AH is 05 and the value of AL is 06. So after unpacking, we have to add 3030 in order to convert into ASCII. So here totally this AL and AH means the result will be stored in AX register, which is having AL and AH, 8 bit register. So AL is here 06, AH is 05. Or AX, 3030. So OR operation means addition operation will be performed. So for this value which is present in AX register, that is 0506, for that 3030 value will be added. Okay. So here we will have 36 and here we will have 35. After performing the OR operation, this is AX register which is there in place of destination. So after performing the OR operation, this 35, 36 value will be again stored in the AX register. So this is how we have to write the assembly language program to convert packed BCD to ASCII number. So here now the value of AX will become 35, 36. and the next instruction INT03 will be executed. Here it represents end of the program. So for each assembly language program, compulsory the last instruction should be INT03 only. So we should not write any lines after this INT03. Once if INT03 is executed, whatever the lines if you write after this instruction, they will be ignored. So everything we have to write before INT03 only. And for converting the packed BCD to ASCII, we have taken the input, that is a packed BCD number we have taken as input in a register AL, that is 56 is the number what we have taken. After converting into ASCII, it has changed to 35, 36, 30, 30 will be added. And since this is a 16-bit data, it will be stored in a 16-bit register. Now, we will see how to convert hexadecimal number to ASCII number. So generally here, hexadecimal numbers will be existing from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So after 9, the hexadecimal numbers will be A, B, C, D, E and F. So here these are the hexadecimal numbers. So in order to convert these hexadecimal numbers into ASCII numbers, we have to do here. So from 1 to 9, we have to add a value 30. Then this numbers after converting into ASCII. So these are the hexadecimal numbers. So after converting that into ASCII, so this 1 will become 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38 and 39. But here the numbers from A to F, in order to convert that into ASCII, we should add 37 for this. So here, let us consider a value 0A, the first value. We have to add 37 for this value. So generally here, A represents 10. So we have to add. So here, A should be added with 37. So A means generally it is 10. 10 plus 7, the value will be 17. Now this 17 value after converting into hexadecimal, it will become 10. So here we have to place 1 and so here it is, the remainder is 1. So here we have to place 1 and 3 plus 1, the value is 4. Now the hexadecimal value of this A will be 41. So similarly for B, it becomes 42. Next for C, it becomes 43. For D, it is 44. For E, 45. And for F, it is 46. So these are the ASCII equivalents for this hexadecimal inputs. Now we have to convert, we have to write the assembly language program to convert this hexadecimal numbers into ASCII numbers. So if the input what we are giving should be in terms of hexadecimal, so it may be either in between 1 to 9 and it may be from A to F because the input will be hexadecimal value. So after converting that into ASCII, if it is between 1 to 9, 30 will be added for that. If it is from A to F, 37 value will be added. Now we will see how to write an assembly language program to convert this hexadecimal number into ASCII number. And so here, this is the program. Okay. So here, first move SI comma 2000. So if you observe in the previous program, we have considered only one input. So we have taken registers and we have moved that input into that registers. But here in this program, we are going to convert some 2 to 3 numbers, hexadecimal numbers, into ASCII numbers. So since that inputs we are taking more, in this program we have considered the memory locations in order to move all the hexadecimal inputs. So the SI register, that is index register, and DI, destination index register, these two index registers are used because here we are going to consider a string that consists of set of inputs which are in the form of hexadecimal. Now, so move SI comma 2000, if that is the case, the value SI will be moved into 2000, the value 2000 will be moved into SI register. And move DI comma 3000 means this 3000 value will be moved into DI registers. That means here, whatever the hexadecimal values we are taking as input, they have to be given in this 2000 location. After converting into ASCII, it will be stored in this 3000 location. And move CX comma 0003. So here CX value, it is a counter register. So here the value 03 will be moved into that CX. So it means this is the count value, which says how many number of inputs we are going to take. How many number of hexadecimal inputs we are going to take. So here there is only 3. So only 3 hexadecimal numbers can be converted into ASCII. So if you want to take more inputs, the value in the CX register can be changed. And so move AL comma SI. So here SI is kept in the brackets. So generally, what is this SI? Here SI is represented with a memory location 2000. Okay. So here it is considered that there are 3 inputs. So 2000, 2001 and 2002. The 3 inputs can be considered. Any inputs can be considered. So let us consider some values which lie in between 0 to 9. So for example, here we can take 4. And let us consider some example inputs that lie in the range A to F. So for example, here let us take 0B and this is 0E. So these are the inputs we are taking. After converting that into ASCII, it will be stored in destination index registers. So here destination index register, it is initialized with 3000. So here we have to take 3000, 3001 and 3002. Now this 04, after converting into ASCII, it will become 34. So how it will become 34 means this is the program that will be executed. So move AL comma SI. So it represents the contents of SI will be moved into AL register. So present here the value of SI is 2000. So the value present in this 2000 is 04. So 04 is the value which will be moved into AL register. And CMP represents the instruction compare. So compare operation will be performed between the content present in AL and 0A. And we know that while this comparison operation is performed, the result will not be stored anywhere. So compare operation means the value which is present in AL is 04. 04 minus 0A. So if you perform this negative operation, the result, whatever we are getting here after performing the subtraction operation, the result will be negative. So it represents the carry bit is set. So if the carry bit is set, see the next instruction is JC FWD. So this FWD is a label here. That means saying the control, if this condition is executed, go to the label FWD. So here this is JC. JC represents jump if carry, or simply to say if carry bit is set, jump to the label FWD. So here this is the label FWD and the control will be executing this instruction. So here this instruction will be skipped. It will not be executed. So directly the control will be moving to this, and this instruction or AL comma 30 will be executed. So OR operation means the content present in this AL will be added with this 30. So here, according to this, the content present in AL is 04. For this, the value 30 will be added. And this will be stored in this AL register. Why? Because it is in place of destination. So present, the value that is stored in this AL register will be 34. And here, from AL register, here AL register is handling 34. So this 34 value will be moved into this DI register. Okay. So here the value of DI present is 3000. So into the 3000 location, the value AL is here 34. This 34 will be moved into 3000. So in this 3000 location, we will get a value 34. So here this 04 is a hexadecimal input. It has been converted into ASCII value. Now, after this, the next instruction will be executed like increment SI, increment DI, decrement CX. Why? Because one input has been completed. So in order to take the next input, so this is the value of SI, which should be incremented by 1. And this is the value of DI, which should be incremented by 1. So that is why we have to use increment SI. So initially, the value of SI is 2000. If you write increment SI, it becomes 2001. And next one is increment DI. So the value of DI, previously it was 3000, it becomes 3001. And decrement CX, because as soon as one input has converted, the counter value will be decremented by 1. So the value of CX becomes 0002, or simply 02. And J and Z up. J and Z represents here jump if not 0. So jump if not 0 means jump if the value, whatever the instruction that is written previous to this J and Z, it says the result of that condition. So jump if not 0, that means if the CX value is not 0, go to the label up. Okay, up is a label. So if it is going to the label up, again the same instructions will be repeated. Okay, so since here the value of SI and DI are incremented by 1, next, if here again the execution starts, move AL comma SI. So the content present in SI will be moved into AL. Now, the content of SI is here 2001. So in 2001, there is a value 0B. So that 0B value will be moved into AL register. And next instruction is compare AL comma 0A. So here in AL present, there is 0B. That 0B will be compared with 0A. So here, whatever the result we are getting, it will be positive. So positive means we can say the carry flag is not set. So here, JC forward. Jump if carry only, the label will go to forward. That means this instruction will be skipped. But here, the carry bit is 0. That is why this next instruction add AL comma 07 will be executed. That means the content which is present in AL register, for that this 07 value will be added. So present here the value of AL is 0B. For that 0B, 07 will be added and it will be stored in AL register. And so here if you see, for 0B, if you add 07, so we know that the value of B is 11. So A represents 10, the value of B is 11. So 11 plus 7, it is 18. If you convert that into a hexadecimal, it will become 1, 2. So here there is 1, 2. The value is 1, 2. So here the value 0B plus 07 is 12, it will be stored in AL register. And after that, or AL, 30 is there. And for this AL, whatever it is present, now it is 12. For the value 12, the value 30 will be added. And it will be stored in this AL register. And here the value will become 42. And considering this 42 as AL value, it will be moved into DI register location. Present, the value of DI has been incremented. So it is 3001. So into 3001, this 42 value will be moved. And here the value will be 42. After that, again, since the counter has not become zero, the third input is there in order to go to 2002. And in order to store the result in 3002, we have to increment the value of SI and increment the value of DI. So if you increment the value of SI, it becomes 2002. And if you increment the value of DI, it becomes 3002. So the counter becomes 01. So jump if not 0. The counter value is not 0. So again, it will be going to the label up and the same instructions will be repeated. So if the same instructions repeats, the hexadecimal value which is present in the next location, that is 2002, is 0E. So this 0E will be converted into ASCII value. So the ASCII value of 0E is 45. So in this way, the hexadecimal value will be converted into ASCII value. So mainly, if it is lying in between 0 to 9, only 30 value will be added to that number. If the hexadecimal value is from A to F, 37 will be added to that number. So this is the program to convert hexadecimal into ASCII. And the last instruction is INT 03, that is end of the program. Now coming to the observation table. So we have taken all the inputs, which is in the form of hexadecimal in the memory location. 2000, 2001 and 2002, because CX value we have taken is only 3. And any inputs we can consider which is in the form of hexadecimal. So I have taken one number which lie in between 0 to 9 and another two numbers which lie in the range A to F. And after converting that into ASCII value, so the value 04 will become 34 and the value 0B will become 42 because 37 will be added for that, not 30, and the value 0E will become 45. So this is the assembly language program to convert hexadecimal number into ASCII number. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.